What's up, you guys, and welcome back to Gal. Today I'm showing you three awesome time tricks in Premiere Pro. The first one, you're going to learn how to take shaky footage and turn it into smooth, buttery slow motion. The second one, you're going to learn how to take a long video clip and turn it into a time lapse. And third, you're going to learn how to create speed ramps and variable speed using time remapping in Adobe Premiere Pro. And then I'm going to show you guys a brand new tool called Animation Builder by Smashworks. With Animation Builder, you can use the Essential Graphics panel to create easy and fluid text animations, shape animations, and custom image animations. So stay tuned to learn about how that works after the tricks. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump on in. So here I have this B-roll shot of the Osmo action. I shot this on the Sony RX100 at 120 frames per second. Now I just did this handheld and I didn't really mind that it was a little bit shaky because I knew that I would be able to slow it down and add warp stabilization in Premiere Pro. So this is a common technique I do in a lot of videos, and if you guys shoot at 120 frames per second, you'll get more information so you can create more fluid slow motion. The first step is to apply the warp stabilizer. So go to effects, search warp stabilizer, and then double click to apply it on the clip. Now what this will do, if you go up to the effect controls here, you can see that it's analyzing the frames and then it will stabilize it to create smoother motion. All right, so it finished, so let's play it back to see how smooth it is. So you can see it's a lot smoother, but it's fairly quick and it could be slowed down. So this is where I use my favorite tool in Premiere Pro, the rate stretch tool. If you hit R on your keyboard, you can enable the rate stretch tool and then just pull the end of the clip to lengthen it out to get a different speed. But the issue here is that you cannot apply a warp stabilizer and change the speed on the same clip, but there's a workaround here. So I'm just gonna hit Command Z or Control Z on a PC to undo this. And then what you can do is go back to the selection tool here, right click on this clip and nest it. And then we can call this Osmo nested, anything like that, and then hit okay. And what this did was it created a new sequence and it embedded the sequence inside of the sequence. So you can see over here, Osmo nested is its own sequence now. So now we can use the rate stretch tool on this nested sequence. So I'm gonna hit the rate stretch tool again and then expand this out to slow it down. So right now it's at 50%. We can expand this out a little bit further, let's say to around 4 seconds or so. And let me just go up here to right click to clear my in and out. Now let's go ahead and hit enter or return to render this. And now let's play it back. At first glance, it looks a lot better than the original shot, but we can make it even smoother using this trick. You can right click and change the time interpolation from sampling, which just repeats frames, and use optical flow, which essentially generates new frames. It predicts what those new frames will look like. Now you'll have to render it out again, but let's render it out and then see the result. So this is the result with optical flow. You can see how much more fluid it is. Again, this is a really easy way to shoot B-roll. Just shoot at a high frame rate, and then you can create really buttery, smooth, slow motion shots. It's really easy to do. Also, you don't need to shoot in 120 frames per second. You can even do this with, you know, 24 frames per second, 30 frames per second, or 60 frames per second. It may not be as smooth as this, but it's definitely worth a shot to try out in your next video. Now in Premiere Pro 2020, there was a new update where you can actually remap a shot and speed it up to 20,000%. Before in 2019, let me open up the same shot here in 2019. If you right click on this video and go to Show Clip Keyframes Time Remapping Speed, this will enable time remapping. And if you hover over this line here, you can see that we could just bring it up to 1,000%. Let me zoom in here with the navigator. So you can see the limit is 1,000. I can't go above 1,000. I'm stuck at 1,000%. But now here in Adobe Premiere Pro 2020, if I right click on this clip and go to Show Clip Keyframes, Time Remapping, then Speed, If I hover over this line, click and drag up, there is no limit at 1000%. I can continue to go all the way up to 20,000%. Now this is just a 7-minute clip, so it might be overkill to go up to 20,000%, because if I do go all the way up, if I keep scrolling to 20,000, it actually makes this clip only 2 seconds, which is not very long. So in this case, what I would do is probably bring it back down just a bit more until it seemed right. And then I would just render this out really quickly. I'm going to render in and out so you can see what it looks like. So now that it's all rendered out, I'm going to hit the loop playback button. This is a cool tip if you guys ever want to loop playback, just hit this button here. If you don't see it here, go to the plus icon and just find it here and just drag that into your menu bar. So let's go ahead and play this back. I'm playing it back at a quarter resolution just so the playback is more smooth. So you can see that the long clip that was 7 minutes in duration is now more like a time-lapse shot. So that's one other cool trick to play with time in Premiere. So this is a shot of a flyboarder, and oftentimes when you're doing time remapping, you may want to slow it down and then speed it back up again to really show off a move. So this is where time remapping and using keyframes to change the speed and make speed ramps comes in handy. So just like before, we're going to right click, then select show clip keyframes, time remapping, speed. And now this will enable time remapping. So let's say in general, we want to slow this clip down. Rather than going up, which increases the speed, we're going to go down this time. And let's say we want it to be at around 70%, but then we want it to slow down even more when he starts to turn. So let's say we want him to slow down right about here. You're going to use the pen tool or hit P on your keyboard, click there. And now let's go to the moment where we want him to speed back up again, and let's create another keyframe here. So just click. Now what we can do is go back to the selection tool or press V on your keyboard and just reduce the speed between these points, let's say down to 22%. And you can see that the clip gets longer because you're expanding this section, you're making this slower. So you see it's just a hard drop between this speed and a lower speed. What you can do is expand this so that way it's more of a ramp. So that way it gradually reduces speed. So we can do the same thing here. And better yet, when you click on one of these handles here, you can actually make the curve exponential. So it's less of just a straight ramp and more of a speed ramp that goes from slower to faster, quicker. All right, so let's go ahead and play this back and see how it looks. So right now it's kind of staggered because, again, as I said before, it's better to shoot in 120 frames per second because there's more information already. Now this is a 25 frame per second shot. Okay, so this is definitely does not have as much frames in it, but what you can do to make it smoother is right click and again, go to time interpolation, optical flow. All right. And now let's hit enter or return to render it out and let's see the results. So now that it's rendered out, let's see the results. Remember, this right here is at 70% speed. If you hover over the line, it'll tell you the speed and then it ramps down and it goes to 22%. And then it goes back up again here to 70%. So let's see how it looks. So you can see it just looks super cool where the guy is in full motion and then it slows down and then it speeds back up again. And so now I'm going to show you guys this brand new tool that I've discovered called Animation Builder by Smashworks. It's a really cool tool that allows you to animate text without any keyframes. You can build shapes and animate them with the presets that they've included. And so using the tool, I'm going to show you guys how to create a really simple and easy logo opener without using any keyframes. So when you first install the Smashworks Animation Builder, you'll get this folder and it has the custom image mogurts all here in different resolutions, the shape builder mogurts, and the text builder Mogurts. Now I'm working in an HD sequence, not a 4K, so I'm going to be using the horizontal one, and the V here just stands for vertical. So what I'm going to do first is import the HD Mogurt into my Essential Graphics panel. So if I click on the Install Motion Graphics template, I can then go into this folder, into the text builder, and import the HD Mogurt, which is awesome. And then here it is, it appears right here at the top. Now the second Mogurt, this is where it gets really cool because you can actually import your own logos or any imagery. So before you go in here and import one of these custom image Mogurts, you first want to customize it using their customizer tool. So double click on this URL to open this up, and then it will open up this online tool where you can upload that Mogurt and customize it. So we can just drag and drop it here. So let's go back to the Finder, and I'm going to drag and drop my custom image HD Mogurt. And here I can see that there are 10 different placeholders for images. So you can put any type of image here. You can use JPEGs, PNGs, EPS, everything listed here. And the way you do that is, let's go back over here. You can see that I have two logos that I use all the time. My logo, the solid color one, and then just the white one, which looks like that. So I'm going to drag and drop this one in the first placeholder, and then the white logo in the second. And then I'm gonna click Generate Template and just give it a quick name. I'll put Gal Intro and just click this button, and it will replace the images and give you a new Mogurt with your images. So then what you can do is you can show this in the Finder. It automatically goes into the downloads, and then you can just drag and drop it in here like so. Now we can go back here and install this Mogurt. Let's go back to Animation Builder, and then we can import this new Mogurt. So now they are both here, and this is where it gets fun. So I'm going to drag and drop this text Mogurt in here. It's gonna take a second to load. So as I scrub through, you can see what the animation is. It goes down at the end because the duration is 10 seconds. And this interface text just gives you a preview of the parameters that you're going to change over here. So if you change anything over here, it will be reflected in the interface text. It's completely optional to have this on though. So I'm just going to go ahead and turn this off. So now I'm just going to quickly update the content of the text, the font size, etc. So now that I've updated the font size and the location, I'm actually going to change it so that way it's not going from up to down, but instead from left to right. And to do that, you're going to go under step 5 here and change this to 90 degrees. So now it's going to go from left to right. Like so. Another thing that you can add is some other secondary animation stuff down here. Under the text reveal, we can make it grow in so that way it gets smaller to big. So grow in is number 3, so I'm going to change that to number 3, and that will change that. And for the speed, I don't want it to last for 10 seconds. I think that that is a little long, so I'm going to change this to 5 seconds, and then it will update. So before we render it out, I want to add in the logo. So I'm going to drag and drop this on top of the text here. And you can see that it automatically has my Gal logo because that was the first placeholder. Now I want to change this to the white logo. So I'm going to change this to number 2, which is the second placeholder, and it will change it to my white logo. I'm also going to turn off the interface so I can better see what's going on. And then next, you can choose the type of animation. I'm going to animate the position still. I think that's good. It's at number 1. And then I'm going to have it bounce. So I'm going to choose number 3 here. For the speed, I'm going to have it stay at 3, see how it looks. We can always change that later. I like it going up to down at 180, so I'm going to keep that. And then I'm going to change the duration to 6. Another thing, I'm just going to make the logo just a tad bit smaller. So I'm just going to reduce this to around 85. And next, let's hit enter to render it out. And just like that, we have our simple little logo animation, and we didn't have to do any keyframing. It's really cool. It has this nice little grow in and little bounce action. So I'd highly recommend Animation Builder. Go check it out. I'll put a link in the description box below. There's lots of other creative use cases. For example, down here on their website, they have this creative use case where somebody built this entire animation using Animation Builder, using custom images and shape builder. So definitely check it out. Link in the description. So that's it for this video, you guys. If this video helped you out and you like this content, be sure to give it a thumbs up. If it gets to 5,000 likes, it really helps me out because then I know that you guys love this type of content. And a huge shout out to all my patrons. If you guys become a patron, you can get some free templates each month that I sell on my store. Thanks again, you guys, for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.